This is the first person we've interviewed who.
Good long.
This guy.
Her name is Claire, right?
Claire, yeah.
Claire, can you move, or one way or the other, yeah. Gary's the guard of the door. All right, I am rolling.
All right, Tom, talk a little bit about how St. Vincent de Paul helped you out of a tough spot.
Oh, where do I begin? They helped me, navigate the pitfalls of being on the verge of becoming homeless. They would help me with expenses here and there, with food, any household items I may have needed. And when it came time, they finally arranged for me to get into Cardinal Manning, which was kind of a godsend.
You never would have thought you'd have been in that position, though, would you?
No. It was devastating. It can happen to anyone. I didn't think it would happen to me, but it did, and I thank God every day that I was able to get in touch with St. Vincent de Paul, because that saved my life.
You say, you know, this can happen to anyone, and people have stereotypes in their head about the homeless, or even people that they see on Skid Row.
Sure.
If somebody watching this sees you, I go, this guy, how's he homeless? How was he in that situation? How do you get to that point? A couple of things go wrong?
Oh, yes. I mean, a combination of factors. The financial crisis, loss of work, a lot of little things, but it's very scary. And when I knew I was going to be in trouble, when I knew I was going to have problems, I was, you know, seeking help and finding people who, you know, might have suggestions or ideas. And a friend of mine mentioned, you know, you might want to call St. Vincent de Paul. I said, okay. I didn't do it right away. I waited a while, and then things got worse. I said, boy, I better call them. Best thing I ever did.
You want to try and make it work on your own, right? You don't want to end up asking somebody for help of any kind.
Yes, that's true. But, you know, they helped me get me on my feet. I recovered. I have housing right now. So I became a Vincentian. And now I help the homeless. I help Claire and her, you know, I'm a member of the conference. Mm-hmm. So I help out where I can now, and that's very satisfying.
You know more than most what it's like to walk a mile in that person's shoes. You've been in those shoes.
Sure, I've been in those shoes. Not as bad. As I said, I mean, I was on the verge of being out on the street, and St. Vincent de Paul came to the rescue. But I see these people downtrodden and with no hope, and I say, there but for the grace of God go I. So.
You think when you speak with them that you're able to give them some hope?
Yes, because you have to have hope. It's tough when you become homeless. You know, hope, optimism, kind of, it's not something you count on like you normally do. But I recovered, and I'm in pretty good shape. So I find it, I do try and help, and I just say, look at me, I'm an example. You know, there's an expression, staring into the abyss. Well, I almost fell into the abyss. It was pretty grim. But I can't say enough about the Society of St. Vincent de Paul. The manifesto, no act of charity is foreign to us, and that's very true. And, you know, I'll say it again. I'm very thankful that I was able to, that they helped me. I sought them out, and they helped.
Very good. Very good. Very well spoken.